Hey, what's up guys? Sean Nalawani here of EliteImpactLabs.com, and today I'm responding to a few requests that I've received to do a review of creatine hydrochloride supplements, and so that's what this video today will be about. So we started off with the original creatine monohydrate back in around the mid-1990s, and since then a huge list of new and improved creatines have been added to that list. And one of the most recent of those forms is creatine hydrochloride, or creatine HCl for short, which is a form of creatine that is created by attaching a hydrochloride group to the creatine in order to create a salt. And like most of the other breakthrough creatine forms on the market, creatine HCl is surrounded by a lot of hype and big claims about its muscle building effectiveness in comparison to creatine monohydrate. But is creatine HCl superior to creatine monohydrate? Well, let's examine the main claims that are made about creatine HCl in comparison to creatine monohydrate, and then you can basically just make the decision for yourself. So the first major claim is that there is no loading phase required with creatine HCl. Now, this is a totally irrelevant point because there is no need for you to perform a loading phase with any form of creatine, whether it's creatine monohydrate or creatine hydrochloride. A loading phase can help you see the results in a shorter amount of time, 5 days as opposed to about 20, but a standard 3 to 5 gram per day dosage of creatine will result in full creatine saturation of the muscles within about 2 to 3 weeks. The second claim is that there's no bloating with creatine HCl. Now, I've talked about this 100 times in the past, and I don't even really know where this idea came from, but creatine monohydrate does not cause bloating of any kind. Creatine does require additional water in order to be stored in your muscle tissue, but that water is stored inside of the actual muscle cell itself and not directly underneath your skin. And this is actually one of the primary benefits of creatine usage, because it gives your muscles a fuller and harder appearance. So sure, creatine hydrochloride doesn't cause bloating, but neither does creatine monohydrate. The third claim is that creatine HCl will not give you an upset stomach. Now, creatine monohydrate is the most studied sports supplement in history, and when used within the recommended 3 to 5 gram per day dosage, it does not produce any unwanted side effects in terms of upset stomach or GI distress in otherwise healthy individuals. So again, another irrelevant point. Claim number four, you don't have to cycle off of creatine HCl. Now, I just covered this in a video a couple weeks ago, and there's no need to cycle your creatine, whether it's creatine monohydrate or creatine hydrochloride. External creatine consumption does not alter your body's natural production of creatine when you stop supplementing with it, nor does cycling reduce the side effects, because there are none, nor does it enhance the results any further when you cycle on and off. So again, this is just another irrelevant point that's used to market creatine HCl. And claim number five is that there's no water retention with creatine HCl. Now, I just mentioned this a couple points ago, but increased intracellular water retention is actually one of the primary benefits of creatine supplementation. This is not a drawback. Creatine requires water in order to be stored in your muscles. And to say that creatine HCl does not cause water retention is basically saying that it doesn't work. Both creatine hydrochloride and creatine monohydrate are going to cause intracellular water retention, and this directly translates to improved muscle growth and performance at the gym. So when it really all comes down to it, there's just no good reason to deviate from the monohydrate form when it comes to creatine supplementation. 2 to 3 weeks of consistent creatine monohydrate use at the recommended dosage of about 3 to 5 grams per day will result in a near 100% saturation of your muscle tissue and without any unwanted side effects. And there's really nothing more that you can ask for there. It's not that there is necessarily anything bad about creatine hydrochloride itself, but why pay eight to 10 times the cost when you can achieve the maximum benefits that creatine has to offer by simply using the monohydrate form? One of the primary reasons why creatine HCl is claimed to be superior to monohydrate is because it's more water soluble, and so it requires a smaller dosage. But on a per serving basis, despite that, it still ends up being a significantly higher price. And on top of this, creatine HCl is still a relatively new supplement. And at this point, there really isn't any concrete research that directly demonstrates its effects in comparison to the creatine monohydrate form. So the bottom line here is that you're free to use whatever form of creatine you like. And I'm sure when I post this video, there's gonna be a few people in the comment section who are defending creatine HCl and who claim that they got better results with it. But at the end of the day, creatine monohydrate is the most researched sports supplement ever released, and it has a near 100% absorption rate in the body, no side effects, and it's also the most cost-effective form as well. So unless new research surfaces which shows a different form of creatine to be superior to monohydrate for building muscle or enhancing gym performance, I think the choice is pretty much a no-brainer at this time. So I hope you found the information in this video lesson useful. If you do want to check out a very high quality creatine monohydrate based supplement, you can check out our MuscleAmp formula over in the EliteImpactLabs.com store, which I'll link in the description box below. If you did enjoy the video, as always, please make sure to hit the like button, leave a comment, and subscribe to stay up to date on future videos. Also, make sure to grab your free 28-day mass building plan using the link in the description box as well. That includes a free workout plan, meal plan, and supplement guide over on EliteImpactLabs.com. And make sure to join the Elite Impact Labs Facebook page for daily articles, videos, tips, and bodybuilding supplement giveaways. Thanks again for watching this video. I appreciate all of the support, and I'll talk to you again soon with more free tips.